Blackstone presents Into the Forest, Tales of the Baba Yaga, edited by Lindy Ryan. This book is read by Zura Johnson, Kimberly M. Wetherell, Rachel Jacobs, Mikhaila Aaseng, Angela Lynn, Betsy Foldes-Meiman, and Chanté McCormick.
Preface by Lindy Ryan. When the idea first came to put together a women in horror anthology, it took some time to decide on the theme. There have been several incredible female-focused anthologies of late. We wanted to add to that growing library with a collection that captured the very essence of those who identify as female horror writers, wild and fierce and feminine. Baba Yaga is all of those and more. Thus, she became our muse and our subject. With mortar and pestle in hand, we set out to create an anthology. Instead, we found a sisterhood. Hundreds of submissions flooded our call. Stories from women worldwide, from every walk of life, and each breathtaking and inspiring in its own right. As we commenced the arduous but exciting task of selecting the right pieces for this collection, we were reminded of something wonderful. There is a wealth of talent among women in horror today. And women in horror today. Wild women. Women with imagination, with power, and with voices demanding to be heard. Women who, regardless of any differentiator that might be applied to separate us, retain the spirit of Baba Yaga. Slavic in origin, many have grown up hearing folktales about Baba Yaga, though she will undoubtedly be new to some. Whether you're meeting Baba Yaga for the first time, or this is one of many trips to her familiar chicken-legged hut, we invite you to journey with us to meet the witch, who waits deep in the forest, and read her tales. Many will find her warm, while others will pronounce her wicked. These stories are, like Baba Yaga herself, limitless and unpredictable. They are wild, they are fierce, and they are feminine. Thank you to every woman who shared her story. Thank you to every contributor to this book. Thank you to every listener who listens to this collection and finds their sisterhood. We are Baba Yaga, and it is with great delight that we take you into the forest. A special and not insignificant thank you is due to Tony Miller, our favorite Baba Yaga, without whom this anthology would not have become the powerful collection that it is. Foreword by Christina Henry. Baba Yaga is a character who almost needs no introduction. The broad strokes of her are there, embedded in our collective memory. The long-nosed crone with her walking house and iron teeth and penchant for cannibalism. We know her comic forms of locomotion. Her house has chicken feet. Her flight is powered by a mortar pushed along by a sweeping broom. This whimsy should make her more accessible and less opaque. Yet it somehow increases her menace, makes Baba Yaga's cruelty sting more. In the traditional stories, Baba Yaga is always ugly, always old. She has no need of the male gaze, nor the beauty standards that come with it. This is no Snow White stepmother admiring her beauty in the mirror. Her ugliness is, too, not necessarily a descriptor for the personality within. In folk tales, being physically unattractive is often a shorthand for villainy. The beautiful are virtuous, and the ugly are not. While Baba Yaga is rarely virtuous in the traditional sense, she's often fair and sometimes even kind, though these qualities are not easy to predict. She lives on the borders of places, in the margins far from a safe and civilized society. Her house will appear at the edge of a wood, or sometimes deep in a forest, but on the thin line between kingdoms. Sometimes it is on a seashore, where the safety of land becomes the uncertainty of the ocean. She is a wild thing, tied to the earth. She can be a friendly hand to a passerby or a monstrous one, a snake that can choose to strike or turn its fanged head away in mercy or indifference. Even her name, Baba Yaga, is a reflection of the uncertainty of her identity, of her core character. Baba is, depending on the Eastern Slavic language and the time period it is spoken, either grandmother, or old woman, or fortune teller, or midwife, or perhaps foolish woman, though only a true fool would think Baba Yaga foolish. Yaga is a term of even more mysterious provenance. According to Andreas Johns, author of Baba Yaga, the ambiguous mother and witch of the Russian folktale, the word Yaga might be sourced from the Serbo-Croatian Eca, horror, shudder, or chill, or perhaps from the Polish Getzo, witch, evil woman, or fury. It might be, according to Sibylline Forrester's essay, Baba Yaga, the Wild Witch of the East, that Yaga originally meant horrible, horrifying. If Baba Yaga originally played a role in the secret corpus of myths or initiation rituals, a taboo might have discouraged people from saying her name in other contexts. The scholarly speculation on the source and meaning of Baba Yaga's name is vast and deep, probing the roots of languages that have been traditionally tied to her stories, searching for one clear and defined answer. But ambiguity remains. Her name might mean nothing, and it might mean everything. Baba Yaga's name remains as shrouded in mystery as her true nature. The vast body of folktales around Baba Yaga reflects these many natures. Baba Yaga isn't always, strictly speaking, the same woman from story to story. She's not always even one woman. Sometimes she is three sisters, each more crafty and cruel than the last. Sometimes she is a single, benevolent, wise woman, assisting fair maidens and lost princes. Sometimes she is a trickster, offering weary travelers comfort while waiting for her victims to fall asleep before murdering them. Sometimes she is both mother and daughter, crone and maiden in the same tale. She often longs for the sustenance of Russian blood, which she could sniff out even if she were blind. She frequently asks the rather loaded question, "Are you doing a deed, or are you fleeing a deed?" In one story, a nameless lovely maiden is pressed into Baba Yaga's servitude by her cruel stepmother. Baba Yaga assigns the maiden several tasks and leaves the chicken-stilt house. Several friendly mice offer the maiden help, and because she is a good and kind girl, she listens to them and completes her tasks. Baba Yaga showers the girl with riches, for Baba Yaga rewards those who do their duty, and eventually, the girl makes her way home to her sour-faced stepmother. However, upon seeing such wealth, the stepmother greedily sends her own daughter to Baba Yaga, expecting the same end. Of course, since blood daughters of stepmothers are often as foolish and cruel as their parents, see Cinderella, which coincidentally may or may not also feature helpful mice, this particular maiden screams and beats the mice that try to assist her. The mice, now dead, cannot help her complete the difficult tasks assigned.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.